Cale Yarborough was unarguably one of the greatest NASCAR drivers to ever live. The driver from Timmonsville, South Carolina, has recorded 3 Winston Cup championships, 4 Daytona 500s, and 83 career wins, and was a member of the NASCAR Hall of Fame class of 2012. But what many fans seem to forget about Yarborough is that he was a car owner. In 1987, Yarborough left Rainier Racing to start and drive for his own team, Cale Yarborough Motorsports. From 1987 to 1992, the team ran with one car, with 2 different numbers in the ongoing years, the number 29 and the number 66, with sponsorships from the Hardys, Phillips, Tropic Arctic, and ran under 2 manufacturers, Oldsmobile and Pontiac. For 1993, Yarborough hired Derek Cope to drive his Bojangles 98, but made the switch to Ford. The first 17 races of the 1993 season did not go good for Yarborough and Cope. They DNF'd 4 times and recorded 1 top 10 with an 8th place finish at Talladega in May. When the team left Pocono in July, they were sitting 28th in points. Yarborough knew the team needed to change and improve, even if it meant switching manufacturers. Back then, if you drove for General Motors, your team had a choice of driving a Chevrolet or a Buick. But for the Ford Motor Company, however, teams could drive a Ford or a Mercury. The thing is, Mercury hadn't competed in the Cup Series since 1980. For NASCAR, Ford had the Thunderbird and Mercury had the Cougar. According to a historical moment story on racingreference.info, the Thunderbird had the upper hand over the Cougar because it had an aerodynamic rear window that helped air flow to the rear spoiler. However, the Cougar had a rear window that looked much like the cars ran from 1981. The window on the Cougar made so that the air did not hit the spoiler, instead going over it and causing less drag but would result in faster speeds. The window design also created low pressure in the rear, meaning less stability in corners and more speed on straightaways. But for Cale Yarborough Motorsports, if it meant it would help the team, it was worth the risk. The team needed to work fast. The next race was 1 week later at Talladega. Crew chief Bob Johnson took the team's Thunderbird and hung Mercury sheet metal to the frame of the car. On Wednesday, July 21st, 1993, Yarborough and his team brought the Mercury to Daytona for a test to justify the speed. Lady Luck, however, was not on their side. Cope made a brief run in the Cougar before rain brought the test to a stop. Crew chief Bob Johnson said, "We thought it was a good idea. Worth a try anyway. We'll probably keep playing around with it and maybe try it out later in the year." But that wasn't the case. With Talladega just 4 days away, the team had to switch back to the Thunderbird. Cope qualified 31st and DNF'd in 36th after blowing his engine. Yarborough and Cope would not improve for 1993. They would finish 37th in final points, and they would never bring back the Mercury Cougar. Cope left Yarborough's team halfway through the 1994 season before being replaced by Jeremy Mayfield and John Andretti. Mayfield would give the team their first pole in 1996, along with 3 top 10s, and Andretti would get 1 pole in 1997 with 4 top 10s and would get the team their first and only win in the 1997 Pepsi 400. The team operated for 2 more years before shutting down in 1999 due to sponsorship and financial difficulties. After that, Cale Yarborough officially retired from NASCAR, but it makes me wonder, how would the Mercury Cougar have performed on the track if it made it into a race? Could this have benefited Cale Yarborough Motorsports? But sadly, we will never know.